So I'm currently the chief of the flight projects office for NASA's launch services program here at Kennedy Space Center. So LSP is responsible for putting all of NASA's science payloads into orbit. So from Mars rovers to weather satellites or Earth observing satellites looking at our planet. My role, I've got a group of mission managers. So we have kind of that project management role to help interface the spacecraft side that's being designed at a different center and interfacing them with the launch vehicles, which we procure commercially. So we buy them from your SpaceX, United Launch Alliance, Orbital Sciences, ATK, and we will provide that interface to make sure the spacecraft's gonna get a good ride uphill. The interface between the vehicle and the spacecraft is all set to the requirements they need. So we manage that process from early advanced planning, which could be 10 years before they launch, to when we buy the rocket for them and provide that launch service about 3 years before launch, all the way through the launch readiness process and getting them up on orbit. I have been working for NASA both as a contractor and a civil servant for about 15 years now. Started my career off in the space station. I worked in the MER in Mission Control in Houston as a safety and mission assurance ops engineer, and transitioned to Kennedy, switched to the launch services program, became a civil servant during that jaunt. Got to work LSP, worked shuttle during the course of that, and then I've switched back over to LSP now. I think project management is definitely, it's about people. So, you know, you gotta manage your risk all along, and risk is technical, schedule, cost. But what really is behind the scenes of all that is each individual's requirements they're bringing to the table. There's someone in project management that's worried about the cost and making sure you do it on time. There's someone worried about the technical requirements and making sure you meet all of those. And there's someone driving that schedule to make sure we get that launch on time and get the best science we can get. So as a project manager, you've got to have all three of those in perspective, but you really have to understand the people behind each of those, because you got to pull the emotion out of the equation and find a way to help everyone work together along the way. So NASA does a great job at giving us, you know, opportunities to take various courses. APPEL is a great resource that's provided various courses I've taken along the way. And the ones that really start to tick into some of the psychology of how people think have really helped. I know as an engineer, we usually, you know, shy away from some of that stuff, but the more you can understand what is going through someone's head when they're trying to defend a requirement, whatever bucket it falls in, any course you can take that helps expand your knowledge of how to work through those, whether it's a crucial conversation or understanding the perspective of a different discipline other than your own, will help you kind of put yourself in everyone else's shoes and work through how to find common ground. I don't think I really knew exactly what I wanted to be when I grew up. So I remember in high school taking an aptitude test that said, you know, you're good in math and science, and you probably should consider engineering or the military. I loved things that went fast. I remember Top Gun being my favorite movie at the time. Didn't think I wanted to go the military route, ended up picking aerospace engineering. Never in a million years thought I was gonna be smart enough for that type of a person that would work for NASA. I figured maybe I'd be in Detroit helping make the next Mustang look more aerodynamic. But my career ended up opening up based on my degree and some opportunities I had in college that kind of opened the doors. So I think what's helped me be successful once I got into my career was really trying to always make a difference, no matter what your role is. You know, trying to bring that value and understanding how you can help the other people around you to be successful. Kind of, I've been lucky to have various mentors along the way. Usually it had been my supervisor. Advice I give a lot of folks now that I mentor is definitely, you need that generationally diverse set of mentors. Because in the world we live in today, we've got multiple cultural generations out here in the workforce today. Another area where any training you can get on the way people think is very important, because you've got folks out here that grew up under very different times than some that are fresh out of college coming to our workforce today. So mentors that have stuck out for me have been ones that have had that diverse background throughout their career, where they worked multiple programs and saw different things along the way. And today I get just as much back from mentoring younger folks that are looking for guidance along the way, because I'm learning from that generation as I get to talk to them. I am Mark Wiese at Kennedy Space Center, and I'm the Chief of the Flight Projects Office for the Launch Services Program.